Hi, I'm Jack Whitehall, and this is me reacting to the most viral clips of Travels with My Father. We start with a clip that has become probably the most viral of all of the clips and shared the most. A travel show. We've been to, I don't know, maybe 20 different countries all over the world. We've been to UNESCO World Heritage Sites, wonders of the natural world. Yet the most shared clip of all of the series is my dad in the back of a car telling Americans to f off.
You know, there's all that, oh, hi, how was your day? And I think, f off. What are you talking about? How was my day? My day has got absolutely nothing to do with you.
I mean, it makes me think, why did we even bother traveling around the world? All of those wasted hours on planes. We could have just put a camera on Michael in the back of a car, driven him around Putney for a couple of hours and asked him to just insult people. Probably would have been watched as much as the show.
I'm absolutely fat.
That was definitely not Michael driving that RV. For all of these shots, he couldn't be bothered, so someone else from the production had to drive the RV around as it was followed with a drone, and Michael sat in the hotel bar drinking.
Famished. Where are we gonna go?
There's a diner up here, it says.
Let's get milkshakes. We'll have a milkshake, please. Okay. I'll have I want some more Rama Lama Ding Dong shake.
Great choice.
And he will have a beauty school dropout shake.
Okay. Did we have an idea of what we wanted to eat today?
I'd like some pancakes.
Always a tense moment when Michael's interacting with an American server as well, especially when we know all about his opinion of American customer service. At any moment, this woman could be told to go f*** herself.
And a burger, please, for him.
Okie doke. And is that going to be for right now?
Yeah, that's great.
Okay, perfect. Let me get these out of the way for you.
I packed a lot of Rennie for this trip.
You know, this is 1950s, themed. I used to watch, was obsessed with cowboy films in the 50s and 60s. Rather like you were obsessed with all those weird films. I can't remember what they were now.
Disney films.
Yeah, all that sort of stuff.
Disney films are not weird.
And then there were the classics like High Noon with Gary Cooper and Grace Kelly.
Cowboys and Aliens, have you seen that with Daniel Craig?
Great movie.
That's a great western.
No, I'm talking about
one of the classics.
Classic British and American westerns.
All his references are so old. I educated him after this on some of the other great westerns. In fact, after this scene, we sat on the RV and watched Brokeback Mountain together. He's not a fan.
Alrighty. So I got some pancakes here.
Thank you.
That's a side of pancakes as well, to be clear. That's not a main meal, that is a side.
And our burger.
You literally can't see over it.
As well. I surprised you, what do you think?
It's gonna keep hunger locked up till dinner. Mm-hmm. Mac and cheese, baby.
All right, some onion rings as well, and our chili cheese fries.
Isn't this so much obesity in America?
Yeah, but look, that's delicious. A mac and cheese double stacked burger.
I mean, how could anyone eat that?
Yeah, well, you don't have to finish it.
Well, I don't want to start it.
Give it here. Swap round.
Okay. I really thought I was going to be able to take this down.
You have these.
This is very much eyes bigger than stomach.
Look at that.
Oh, God. The weight of it.
You just got to commit.
That is disgusting.
What?
No.
What?
Absolutely no way.
You love burgers and you love mac and cheese.
No.
So why would you not like them together?
That's ridiculous. You're getting it all stuck in your...
What does he think I'm going to do with it?
Too, it's just absolutely gross.
Saving some till later?
I thought you were hungry.
Nature's Tupperware.
This puts me off food for almost the rest of my life.
Alrighty, and some shakes for you guys. The I want some more Rama Lama Ding Dong.
That was mine.
There you are, sir.
Oh my God.
Enjoy, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
It's like Guy Fawkes Night here.
My dad's referring to the original Guy Fawkes Night. I think he was in the Houses of Parliament on the day of the plot.
Cheers.
Cheers.
I literally felt so sick after this. I think I may have had a little junder in the loo.
Just look at yourself. Absolutely ridiculous.
Have you ever played Chubby Bunny?
No.
It is kind of amazing that he didn't kill me on this trip.
Have you seen your face?
Chubby Bunny.
It's absolutely ridiculous.
The sugar crush was just horrendous.
You're not still eating. I mean, that really is the rankest thing I have ever seen in my entire life. Well, you're going to have to clean yourself up.
I think I might need to use the bathroom.
You definitely will. Probably in both departments.
Oh, I feel like absolute death.
The state of the toilet on that RV after that meal. It had to be written off. Seriously.
Feeling a bit chundery. Oh,
that was very gassy as well.
Daddy, please. I've eaten too much to do that. Daddy! Daddy! Do you want me to throw up?
No.
Then don't go over the bumps that hard.
There's a softer one for you.
Oh. Moments later, I passed out and was not seen again for days. This was from the first series of travels with my father when we were traveling in the Far East. And I remember thinking when we went out that we'll be safe here because of the language barrier. And no one's really going to understand what Michael's saying, so no one's going to get upset or offended. How wrong I was.
I don't understand if you weren't going to hostel, but you're happy with this. I mean, this is definitely the same.
No, it's nothing.
That creepy doll. Should have left it there on the train, preferably on the tracks.
Why is this backpack on my bed?
Why is that your bed?
Well, because it's by the window. I've been stuck over in that corner.
Why do you need to be by the window?
Well, because I can look out of the window.
We're going to be here
see
at night.
The countryside going past.
We're going to be here at night.
This poor man.
Excuse me, gentlemen. This is your best room. We have liquor over there. Okay, an ice bucket over there.
Lovely.
I'm your steward. If you have any problem, you want to call me, you can place an attendant call over there.
I'm already cringing.
Thank you so much, Stuart. Nice to meet you. A nice man.
Stuart. So cringe.
He said steward, not Stuart. Did he look like a Stuart?
You can see my dad corpsing as well. One of the rare occasions where Michael Whitehall actually starts laughing.
You thought he was called Stuart?
Sorry, how would I know?
Stuart.
Can't even look him in the eye. Poor Stuart. Stuart. No, he's not called Stuart. He is a steward. That's not his name. Oh dear. Yeah. The less of Michael interacting with any of the natives, the better. This was one of those great moments that happened completely by chance. The executive producer had come out to visit us on set for a couple of days, and he'd been traveling in this RV during the morning, and he'd left these wasabi nuts on the RV. It's thanks to him that this great moment of travels with my father happened.
Do you want a nut? No, I don't want a nut. I don't want a nut. Now,
I wasn't taking no for an answer. The minute I saw those nuts had wasabi on, I was like, I'm getting one of these into his mouth if it is the last thing that I do. Quite dangerous considering we were in an RV on a road in Romania. And he was not very good at driving this RV either.
Have you got the map?
Daddy, have a nut. Have a nut?
Hook, line and sinker.
I don't really... Oh,
That little moment as well. That little delay before he registers that he's been stitched up.
That is accurate.
Sorry, they have wasabi on them.
It's absolutely disgusting. What the was that?
It's a wasabi.
I'm going to kill you.
It's a wasabi peanut.
Absolutely kill you. That's the most disgusting thing I've ever eaten in my entire life. Tastes like it came out of your ass.
I had also put it up my ass. In hysterics, but still eating. Oh, if you thought the complaints were bad when it went in, the complaints when it came out the other end. He was not happy. Real ring burner. Oh dear. Happy memories. For me. Not for him. Nothing better than spiking Michael Whitehall's food. I still have nightmares about this experience. Naked yoga, never again. It's definitely a class that you need to arrive early for and make sure that you get a mat at the front of the class. I was stuck at the back. Some of the stuff that I saw that day. I literally saw internal organs. Look, see? Desperately trying to not look directly in front of me. Eyes on the ceiling. Probably we could have done a little bit of shaving before I did that class. A little bit of manscaping maybe wouldn't have gone amiss. But that was the other problem, because we were in America, everyone else was so manscaped. And they were all like buffed and bleached. The man in front of me at one point bent over, and I swear it was like opening a fridge door. Just lit up the room. That's not my best angle.
Yes, perfect. Spread those fingers. Spread your fingers.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
Yes. Careful.
Yeah, there you go. Perfect. It's like a human toast rack in here.
Oh, God.
You could park a bike in the one in front of you.
Come on, Daddy. Just try it.
Must have been a really weird day for the cameraman as well.
Try and do that one.
Aim to see what they're doing.
Oh, that man has a pearl necklace.
They're a lot better endowed than you are. They are.
Not true. He was just saying that for the cameras.
That excuse down there for a penis.
So obsessed with the size of my appendage.
It's like an oak tree, that one.
It is.
Well, I have to be absolutely brutally honest. I mean, if that is LA, then give me Putney any time. What?
Some of the guys are going for a poke. Do you want to go with us?
Go for a what?
Poke bowl.
No, thank you.
Poke bowl, hold the wasabi nuts. Poke bowl, hold the wasabi. He really didn't enter into the spirit of things on that day. He was such a grump. I would only take off his jacket. It's naked yoga, not jacketless yoga. Anyway, I hope that, you know, one day he finally comes around to it and tries. Maybe he should start up his own community of naked yogurists in Putney.